Hello all, my name is Ashutosh. I'm a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I'm creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos.
Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we will going to discuss about Carson rule for the frequency modulated signal bandwidth calculation. So these are the outlines. We're going to start up with the introduction, where we will going to discuss what is the need of this approximated signal bandwidth evaluation, then what basically the Carson rule is, then we will going to discuss the two approximated bandwidth calculation specifically for narrow band frequency modulated signal and wide band frequency modulated signal, and then finally we will going to conclude via discussing some of the numerical problems based on the Carson rule. So we have seen that the ideal bandwidth requirement of FM signal is infinite. In the last lecture, while discussing the bandwidth requirement of FM signal, we find out the ideal bandwidth of the FM signal becomes infinite. But the point is, we cannot transmit the signal which is going to have infinite bandwidth, since all the physical mediums we have, they are of finite bandwidth. So it is not possible for us to transmit the infinite bandwidth signal through the finite bandwidth channel. Hence, we need to find out a basis which may approximate the bandwidth of the FM signal, which contains most of the information, or we could say that we are in a state to transmit overall most of the information signal through the medium or channel. So here the Carson rule is the important rule which is used to calculate the approximated bandwidth of the frequency modulated signal. And according to this particular rule, which was given by the Carson, the FM signal bandwidth is given as the twice of the sum of the frequency deviation and the maximum modulated signal frequency, that is, it is equivalent to twice of delta F plus FM. Mathematically, we could write as bandwidth is equal to twice of delta omega plus omega M. As we had already discussed that if we are talking about your angular frequency, it has been written as delta omega. But if we have to talk about your linear frequency, or we have to perform the measurements in hertz, in that particular case, we will going to use delta F instead of delta omega, and delta FM instead of omega M. So bandwidth would have been given as twice of delta omega plus omega M. Since beta, or you could say the modulation index in terms in case of frequency modulated signal, would have been given as delta omega over omega M. So this could further be rewritten as bandwidth would be equal to twice of beta omega M plus omega M. So that is why we could write as bandwidth is equal to twice of omega M times of 1 plus beta, where beta is nothing but it is the modulation index of frequency modulated signal. So now, according to the applicability of the Carson rule, we may consider two of the cases. And what are they? We basically have to consider two cases in case of narrow band FM signal, and another one is your wide band frequency modulated signal. As the name suggests, in narrow band FM signal, what we can easily conclude is it is a kind of frequency modulated signal whose bandwidth is not much wider, or you could say it is going to have certain narrow band bandwidth. In this particular case, we may approximate as delta omega is very much less than 2 omega M, since we are having narrow band approximation, or we could say that the overall bandwidth is comparable, or you could say much lesser, and it would have been in the order of maximum frequency component of your message signal. And in this particular case, beta is very much less than 1, since beta is equal to delta omega over omega M, and if delta omega is very much less than omega M, so we may write this approximation as beta is very much less than 1. So in this particular case, bandwidth will be equal to twice of omega M. Since beta is very much less than 1, so we could assume that 1 plus very much lesser quantity, it is almost equivalent to 1 only. So this is how your bandwidth is equivalent to, or turns out to be, your twice of omega M, because 1 plus beta is almost equivalent to 1. Hence, for the narrow band signal, the approximated bandwidth can be given as bandwidth is equal to twice of omega M. If you closely observe that, it is actually equal to your bandwidth requirement of your AM signal. So now in the second case, if we consider the wide band FM signal, so as the name suggests, here we are talking about a kind of FM signal where the bandwidth requirement is much larger, or you could say your bandwidth is much higher. So in this particular case, frequency deviation is very much greater than omega m. So in this particular case, we may conclude that beta is much, much greater than 1. So from the basic equation of Carson rule, what we have is bandwidth is equal to twice of delta omega into 1 plus beta. Since beta is too much greater than 1, so we may approximate 1 plus beta is equal to beta. So in this particular case, your bandwidth requirement, or you could say bandwidth approximation, turns out to be twice of beta omega m, since 1 plus beta is almost equivalent to beta, as beta is much greater than 1. So in this particular case, or we could say wideband approximation FM signal, we have bandwidth turns out to be twice of delta omega, where delta omega is the frequency deviation, since beta times of omega m is equal to delta omega. So we can easily write it down, or you could say the approximated bandwidth in case of wideband FM signal turns out to be twice of delta omega. This is what we may conclude. Okay, we can find out that Carson rule basically provides us the approximated bandwidth in two of the cases. First, we are considering about in the narrowband case, and second case is of your wideband case. In the wideband case, we will be having the bandwidth is equal to, or you could say approximated bandwidth is equal to twice of delta omega, and in case of narrowband FM, your bandwidth turns out to be twice of omega m, which is equivalent to your AM signal. So now we will going to discuss some of the numerical example of our FM signal. So the question says that find the bandwidth of the commercial FM transmission if frequency deviation is 75 kilohertz and the modulating frequency is 15 kilohertz. So frequency deviation given to us, delta F is equal to 75 kilohertz, and the modulating frequency FM is equal to 15 kilohertz. Now we have to find out the approximated bandwidth. So from the Carson rule, bandwidth can be given as twice of delta F plus FM, that turns out to be 2 times of 75 plus 15, that is equal to 2 into 90, that turns out to be 180 kilohertz. So this will be the approximated bandwidth of FM signal. This is our answer. So one more time I'm going to let it clear that whatever we have written as in our bandwidth formula, bandwidth would have been given as twice of delta omega plus omega m. So obviously, if we are talking about linear frequency, or we have to answer in terms of hertz or kilohertz, then we have to use this F notation, as the relationship between omega and F, it is quite known to us. Omega is equal to 2 pi F. So we could easily understand that what we have to utilize. So as per the question being asked, you have to automatically utilize this particular equation or result. So now we'll move forward to take another example. So in this particular numerical example, the maximum deviation allowed in an FM broadcast system is 75 kilohertz. That is, delta F is given to us, that is your 75 kilohertz. If the modulating signal is a single tone sinusoid of 8 kilohertz, the modulating signal or the message signal is a single tone sinusoid, that is only one frequency component is present into it, and that frequency component is equivalent to 8 kilohertz. That is, our FM is equal to 8 kilohertz. So we need to determine the bandwidth of the FM signal. So in this particular case, the bandwidth of the FM signal can be evaluated with the help of Carson rule, which states that bandwidth will be equal to twice of delta F plus FM, that turns out to be 2 times of 75 plus 8 kilohertz, that turns out to be 2 times of 83, that is your 166 kilohertz. This is the answer. So the bandwidth requirement for this particular case turns out to be 166 kilohertz. Then in the second part, what will be the bandwidth requirement if the amplitude of the modulating signal becomes doubled? So first we need to check it out what data is given to us. FM is equal to your 8 kilohertz and delta F prior that is given to us, that is your 75 kilohertz. And now in this second case, your AM, or you could say the amplitude of message signal, turns out to be twice of AM since we doubled the amplitude of our message signal. So we need to find out the bandwidth of our new signal. So how we will going to evaluate it? So first of all, we need to check it out that what impact the impact on frequency deviation of doubling this amplitude. So as we know that delta F will be equal to KF times of AM, where this KF is your frequency sensitivity and AM is your maximum amplitude of message signal. So in this particular case, when we have doubled our message signal or the amplitude of our message signal, our delta F prime turns out to be KF into 2 times of AM. Now from this particular relationship, 2 times of delta F, that turns out to be 2 into 75, that is equal to 150 kilohertz. So in this particular case, our frequency deviation turns out to be 150 kilohertz. So from the Carson rule, the bandwidth requirement turns out to be 2 times of delta F plus FM, that turns out to be 2 into 150 plus 8, that is equal to 2 into 158, that turns out to be 316 kilohertz. That will be the answer. Hopefully you have understood this particular problem, and in case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve it out as soon as possible. So these are the references, and thank you very much for your patient hearing. Thank you.